series. I'm Anisha. To know more about my work, you may visit my website www.tarotbyanisha.com. For those of you who are seeking deeper clarity, be it in your love lives or your career, for a personal consultation, you may write to me at tarotbyanisha@gmail.com. Aries, it's quite a dynamic month. In the first couple of days, we still have Mercury that is retrograde, and it's retrograde in a part of your chart that is all about yourself, and it is conjuncting Uranus that is also there in your house of self. So besides the introspection, I think you could have been accused of changing your mind thanks to Uranus being over there fairly often. It could be that for certain weeks or even months you may have thought, yes, this is what I want, and then you could have gone back and said, no, I'm not sure about it. Also, with Mercury retrograde happening in your house of self, it's a time where you could have retweaked a lot of ideas, thoughts, self-beliefs that could have been there, and which is a good thing. And it could also be that you could have taken some feedback seriously, and you could be applying it and thinking, you know, that is this really my conditioning? Do I really think like that? And this is what I'm projecting to the world outside. Mercury goes direct, thankfully, after that, right after the 5th. And on 11th, we have Mars that is there in your house of communication, travel and siblings, and it's squaring Neptune that is there in your house of behind the scenes. And now this is second week is going to be seeing you quite chatty. You're going to be feeling not just quite aggressive, but I think a lot of you are going to be quite assertive. And there's a lot of self-pitching, sharing of ideas, sharing of thoughts, trying to meet up with like-minded people, traveling short distance, you know, more involved in the place, in the community where you live. For some of you, you could be sort of be depending on a sibling as well. Maybe there is some, not just information, but it could be like, it could have to do something with your sibling. Either you could be, taking their opinion, or you could be depending on them, or, you could be called upon to sort of mitigate some issue in the family. On the 19th, we have Venus that is there also in your house of self, and it is opposing Jupiter that is there in your house of marriage. Now, it's quite a wonderful aspect at one side, because Venus is going to be making you want to do your best, because it's there in your house of self, and it will make you want to project yourself the best that you can to your partner. And Jupiter, of course, has been expanding. It's been there for a while in your house of marriage and partnership, and it's going to be enhancing, it's going to be focusing, it's going to make you look at your relationship and at your marriage or even a business partnership quite seriously. And there seems to be a willingness to compromise, a willingness to work through things. And the only thing is that at times too much of a good thing also is not very good. So try and sort of keep your expectations little or low, or don't view a certain partnership with, you know, rose-colored glasses and think that this is how it's always going to be, or it'll forever be very nice and whatever. If there are certain expectations that are slightly unrealistic, maybe you need to be removing your rose-colored glasses, and you need to be looking at things that can be changed, that can be tweaked, and maybe some things that can't be, you need to be working through them. On the 30th, we have Mars that is opposing Saturn that is there in your house of travel, expansion and spirituality. And you're being asked not to go to war, Aries. And as much as you would be, you know, you could be feeling almost wronged, you could be feeling quite aggressive, and you could be feeling as if there's a point that you need to be making, or you're feeling limited or curtailed, try not to sort of burn any bridges during this time. It does involve considerable amount of travel. It does speak about you are being asked to look at things very broadly, Aries. Try not to sort of look at things in a very narrow vision, or look at them through the eyes of having very tunnel vision and saying, I'm not going to be looking at anything besides this. So before you take action, explore all the possibilities, look at the complete scenario, look at it more holistically, and then sort of respond and not react. It's been a pleasure speaking with you, Aries. I'll see you again soon, and thank you so much for watching.